Help me.
Young kids coming with asthma exacerbation.
I'm having a lot of trouble breathing.
Do your best to take some deep breaths for me.
Loss of airway, so we have to intubate.
Beautiful. Love it.
Okay.
Your patient survived.
Awesome.
All right.
Thank you.
There needs to exist an environment in which students can come in a safe space and learn to practice the skills that they're learning without being at the expense of patient safety or the efficiency of an actual healthcare system. So I don't think that any medical school can really exist without this kind of resource.
I consider simulation like a limitless frontier. We do so many different things across so many different disciplines.
Our facilities are available to all members of the Yale School of Medicine community, as well as any member of the Yale New Haven Health Systems community, and that extends all the way from Greenwich Hospital to Westerly Hospital in Rhode Island. We are now a 13,000 square foot space with over 13 high fidelity mannequin simulators.
I think the quality of the mannequins and the tools that we have here in the Sim Center is really incredible.
It's honestly a lot more lifelike than I expected a mannequin to be.
They are able to have physiologic responses. The mannequins blink, they swallow. We can make it so that they are unable to be intubated because of cervical immobility. These mannequins lose their pulses physiologically. We have the largest simulation program in the country.
Historically, medical education is focused on the role of didactic curriculum, so learning in a classroom. The advantage of simulation is that it puts the students in a new and novel environment, gives them the opportunity to practice all the skills that they're learning in the classroom, and get to put them into practice in a novel scenario.
Medical students arrive and start simulation during their very first week of medical school, during introduction to the profession, and then over the course of their 4 years, they participate in the management of 39 acutely ill patients.
It allows the students to get used to the clinical environment before they're actually there in the hospital. It allows us to teach not just the theoretical practice of medicine, but the logistical practice of medicine. Not just knowing what is the right treatment for the patient, but how do you make that treatment happen?
Usually at the beginning, everyone gets assigned a different role. Someone will be in charge of ordering labs, and medications, imaging, and you get to rotate throughout the curriculum and fill all those different roles.
We have a 12-week curriculum where every Friday the students come in for a simulation scenario.
I remember particularly one pediatric simulation with the little mannequin having an asthma attack. So we got to monitor the vitals. We could interview both the patient and the parent. And then I actually saw several patients in the pediatric emergency department with asthma exacerbations. And I was really grateful to have had that simulation as a practice run.
My first time ever intubating a patient was on the simulation here. And now I'm potentially going into anesthesiology down the line, hoping to match next year. Certainly during my first actual intubation, I don't think I would have felt nearly as comfortable if I hadn't had that opportunity to practice it here beforehand.
There would not be a way for me to quantify how much I've taken away from my simulation experience into my clinical environment. I do it constantly, all day, every day.
We have four NIH-funded grants that involve everything from education to physician stress during COVID to agitation in the emergency department. We have a large after-school program to expose underrepresented high school students to STEM education.
What we do in here is reiterate the science, and then we try to give them the practical application of why that science matters. We do that by engaging them in procedural medicine. They learn how to place chest tubes, they learn suturing techniques, among many other procedures. It's an engaging way for them to really understand why the science matters. That after-school program was awarded grant funding through the NIH. Hopefully that's something we can expand to other simulation centers.
The Yale Center for Healthcare Simulation really has such an expansive reach. We do so many things across so many different disciplines and across so many different layers of healthcare and beyond. Everything from your run-of-the-mill teaching with medical students, physician assistant students, nursing students, pharmacists, ED technicians, across countless specialties, and even engage with our community. It's exciting to be a part of it. I really enjoy the work that I'm able to do here. And every single day, I'm taking away more and more.